Guys, so this is my 9-week pregnancy video. Not much is new, a lot of the same symptoms. The number one thing that I'm still dealing with is the nausea. I am still nauseous all the time, 24/7. It seems like, again, like I said in my last video, it seems like I get more nauseous when I don't eat. But again, it's hard to eat when you're feeling nauseous all the time. So I've been feeling really nauseous. In addition to that, I've been really tired more often. I've actually even started to go to bed earlier. I used to be able to stay up until like 11:30 midnight every night, and now I've been going to bed at like 10:30 every night because I just get so exhausted. And I get very cranky when I get tired. My husband will come to bed and I'll be asleep and then he'll want to talk and I'll just be so grumpy, I just don't want to talk to him. I just want to sleep. I can never get enough sleep. I've been eating watermelon nonstop. Watermelon and lemonade are like my two go-tos right now. Every time I go out to eat, I always order lemonade, and watermelon is just so good. I can't get enough of it. I've not really had any food aversions, although I really don't like dry chicken or just like plain chicken or plain steak, dry steak. I can't eat that. It just tastes so bad to me and it makes me want to throw it up. I'm still eating a lot of crackers because they're pretty neutral and I can eat a lot of them. I've been craving like a lot of cheese and different things like that, but I would say watermelon is just my go-to right now. I've always liked watermelon growing up, and then just having it now, it just tastes so good. Anthony and I, we go grocery shopping every week, and every week we buy a watermelon because I eat it that fast. I just love watermelon. I'm actually almost finished with watermelon. We just bought one yesterday and I need to go and cut it up and start eating it. I've noticed this week that I've had a lot more saliva in my mouth, and I think they said that's common during pregnancy, but I just have so much, especially like when I'm brushing my teeth, I notice it a lot. It just like will drool out of me and it's really annoying. Another thing is I still get so much acne on my face. It's all around my jawline and into my neck. I've just been getting acne like crazy. It's super frustrating and annoying. I feel like I'm starting to show a little bit. You'll see in my bump when I show you in a little bit, but I put on a shirt last night and it's a small guy shirt and it's usually big on me, but actually it was feeling a little tight around my tummy area. And so I really feel like, I don't know if I'm showing, I mean, I feel like 9 weeks is a little early to start showing, but it could be bloating. I'm not really sure, but I don't know, that kind of made me excited. Kind of made me excited and kind of made me feel like, oh man, I must look fat, you know, people passing me. So I've been trying to wear like really baggy clothes because we still really haven't told a lot of people. But the big news this week is we have finally told my parents and my family. They were super excited. I had the card laid out on the table, didn't say anything. And my mom and sister came into my home. My mom was in town to help move my sister out of our house and into her new apartment, and my mom put her purse right in front of the card, and so she didn't even see it there. So I was like, oh, so frustrated. So then I had to like draw attention. I had an anniversary card right next to it so it wouldn't stick out, and I was like, oh yeah, we got these cute cards in the mail for our anniversary, like look at this one, it says, it's kind of funny, it says guess what on the front. And then finally she like picked it up to look at it, and she opens it, and she on the inside, you know, it shows the sonogram picture, and then it says like baby Denzel due 2018 April. And so she opens it and she looks at it and she just like stares at it straight face for like a full minute. Like she just didn't, she was like not comprehending, didn't understand. I'm like laughing the whole time. Finally she like looks at me and she's like, you're pregnant? And Allison didn't even see the car, so she was like, what? So Allison is like, oh my gosh, and they're like, oh my gosh, and so they're like screaming, and then they come and hug me, and so of course I had to tell them, like, and they're asking me tons of questions, like, how are you feeling, how far along are you, blah 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 blah. They were shocked. So then I FaceTimed the rest of my siblings, and I have that on video. I'll input that here.
Dark. I cannot see her face.
Felix, get down.
She had it, no way.
Are you at a party?
We've just been having a baby. Don't tell me, Mom.
Don't tell her.
What? Don't tell him. Have him look at this.
Guess what? Chicken butt.
He said, what is that?
Oh, is that Shannon?
Yes!
Yeah!
And they were super excited. Kelly, my younger sister, screamed and she was like, oh my gosh, my sister is having a baby. And Philip was super excited. And then my two youngest brothers, I FaceTimed them. And my youngest brother, Patrick, we showed him the picture, the sonogram, and he was like, what is that? Like, he had never seen a sonogram before. So we had to explain that to him. But all my siblings are super excited. My parents are super excited. My mom's already trying to figure out what she wants the baby to call her. She's ridiculous. So we told my whole family, and then we told Anthony's parents and his brother, and they were super excited. They're not as like emotional as my family, so they were a little more on the cooler side, like, oh yeah, that's so great, congrats. Not like, oh my gosh, like screaming and everything, but they're super excited about it. And Anthony's brother is like really supportive of his as well. So we're just really blessed to have supportive family that, you know, care and support us and are excited for this new baby. So that was really fun telling everyone. Now we have the task of telling all of like our aunts and uncles and cousins and grandparents. So that'll be next on the list. And then after that, we'll tell like close friends. And then at about like the 12 or 13 week mark, we'll put it on Facebook and announce it to the whole world. So we are getting to that point, getting very close to just letting everybody know. And April will be here before we know it. So I've been creating a couple cute little announcements. I'll give you a little sneak peek of it, of what I want to announce it to friends and family who are far away, and we'll just send this picture, and then also like what we're going to put on Facebook. So I bought these cute little things the other day. I bought this this stuffed elephant, and it has a rattle on it, and it's just so, I just thought it was so adorable. It's so small. This could be like the baby's little toy. I just think it would love it. And then I got these cute little boots. Look how tiny. And if you can see, it has a bear face on it. I just think they are super tiny. I was trying to find gender neutral shoes because obviously we don't know what the gender of the kid is going to be yet. So I wanted to put something on there, and they're just so cute. And then the real thing that I'm excited about, I found this on Etsy, and it's a little newborn onesie, and it says, let the adventure begin. And like, look how tiny it because I cannot believe it. So yeah, those are just a few of the props that I've just been playing around with. I'll definitely include a picture of the announcement when it gets closer and have you guys look at it as well. To help with the nausea, I have been taking a B6 vitamin, and that does seem to help a little bit. Some days it helps more than others. Other people I've talked to have taking the B6 vitamin, like they'll take it more than once a day, but I'm just a little worried to do that, so I've just been taking it once, and it helps a little bit. But like yesterday, I was feeling so crappy, and I just didn't want to eat at all. I didn't want to get up. I didn't want to do anything. I was just so miserable. So it's really hard because it makes me not want to cook, and then Anthony is like, well, what am I going to eat? So we've been struggling with that a little bit. I'm hoping that my nausea goes away and that my appetite comes back soon. They usually say, hopefully, that nausea will stop at about 12 weeks, and so I'm just hoping that these next 3 weeks go by super fast. Baby is the size of a grape or a green olive, so still tiny but a little bit bigger, making some progress. I think I was reading that the eyes are starting to form or have formed, but they stay closed until like 20 some weeks. The heartbeat is able to be heard now, but we won't be able to hear it until our next appointment, which will be at 12 weeks. Which is in a couple weeks here. I do notice that at times I'll get super, super hot and I just need like the air blowing on me, or I'll just be super, super cold and I need like a ton of blankets on me, especially now it's becoming fall. But I tend to find that I'm more hot than cold, which is funny because before this, I run cold. I'm always cold. I always need a ton more layers on. So it's kind of funny to like be hot now and need air conditioning on me all the time. So that's kind of different. I've recently started looking into getting a pregnancy pillow. I'm not really sure when to buy it. When did you guys buy your first pregnancy pillow? So, I mean, they're a little more expensive, and there's so many different kinds. There's the wedge, there's the C shape, there's the U shape. I had no idea there were so many different, and then of course all the different brands. But I've kind of narrowed it down to what I want, and I guess, like, I'm not having any trouble sleeping right now, but everybody I talk to is like, oh, you're gonna want it, and so I guess I'm just wondering when I should go buy it. Should I buy it now when I don't really need it, or should I just wait until I find that it's hard to sleep at night, and then run to the store and go get one? They have tons of maternity pillows at Babies R Us, so I'll just get one from there eventually. You can also get them on Amazon as well. So that's kind of the new thing that I'm looking into getting, and it'll just help give me support and that much needed sleep that I need constantly. Yeah, so I think that's all the updates on me. So let me just give you a quick bump a look at my belly. So here it is. Let me move the chair so you can see it against the wall. This is my 9-week bump update. See, so as you can see, like, there is like a bit of a bump here, and I'm just like, is that baby or is that bloating? Like, I'm leaning over, like, I'm just trying to stand up straight, but I mean, look at that. That's like a bump there. I don't know, but they say with your first pregnancy, you're not supposed to be showing until like your second trimester. So I don't know, like, is that bad that I'm showing this much right now? I'm gonna have to Google it and look. So yeah, that is my 9-week update. Stay tuned for 10-week update, and we'll see what's new next week. Bye, guys.